The heat source for the Earth is the sun. Some of the energy from the sun becomes heat energy that warms the planet's surface and atmosphere. Heat is transferred three ways into and through our atmosphere by radiation, conduction, and convection. The total amount of energy that enters and leaves the Earth system is known as the Earth's radiation budget, which focuses primarily on visible light and infrared radiation on the electromagnetic spectrum. The average energy from sunlight coming to the top of Earth's atmosphere is around 341.3 watts per square meter. If you recall, visible light is what we can see. On the other hand, infrared radiation is what we feel as heat. The first way heat is transferred in the atmosphere is through radiation or the transfer of energy from a source, such as the sun. Most solar radiation gets absorbed by the atmosphere or reflected by the clouds. The radiation that reaches the Earth's surface bounces back into the atmosphere, becoming heat energy or infrared radiation. Infrared radiation moves back up through the atmosphere. Most of it becomes trapped by greenhouse gases, while some leaks back out into space. At the ground, dark objects absorb heat faster than lighter colored objects, but cool quicker than their counterpart. Lighter colored objects reflect more visible light than dark colored objects. This is called albedo, or the amount of energy reflected by a surface without being absorbed. Therefore, dark surfaces have a low albedo compared to lighter colored surfaces. Albedo is measured from 0 to 1, or sometimes as a percentage. Conduction is the second way heat transfers in the atmosphere. Conduction is when heat energy moves from one place to another. Heat flows from hot to cold. Air, composed of gases, doesn't conduct as well as a solid or liquid, but in the atmosphere, heat will flow from the hot ground to the cooler air above and warm it. The third way heat moves in the atmosphere is through convection. Convection is the transfer of heat energy in a fluid. Air in the atmosphere acts as a fluid. As hot air rises, the air that replaces it near the ground is more dense, cool air, what we feel as wind. Convection currents are responsible for many weather patterns. Overall, the balance between the incoming radiation of the sun and the energy lost back into space allows Earth to maintain a stable average temperature and climate. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to Mr. Weather's World on YouTube for new videos every Mr. Weather Wednesday.